Hey everyone, it's Will, Gamer Dad, with another video for you. So first off, I'd like to give a shout out to one of my newest Patreon supporters, Frank Wilson. Thanks for your support. Now if you haven't already, make sure you like and subscribe to my channel, I really appreciate it. I also do have a Patreon account for those who want to support me this way. Anyways, in this video, we're going to go over Chapter 1 of the Mythos Western Continent side quests. So far, there's only one chapter released. I believe in Japan, there's actually 7 chapters so far, and there's going to be a total of 10. So we have to wait for further chapters before we can proceed in this game. That being said, some of the main characters that you'll see that are part of our gachas are Melina, for example, Thilalili, Pry, as well as Rosetta. And so these will be featured as we go through the chapters, as well as in this chapter. We also meet a character called Clarty, which is apparently a crystal type lunatic unit that we will get later on through the chapters as we progress. In this particular chapter, it's more like a puzzle-solving quest of sorts. So there's no fighting, you can bring any party that you want to, and you just have to go through a series of yes or no kind of choices in order to proceed properly with the game. That being said, if you make a wrong choice, you'll either have to reset, and there is a kind of an orange orb that you'll unlock partially through this chapter that you can use to reset your motions, or you'll just have to do it wrong, and then you start right from the beginning if you end up making a poor choice. Now, I won't give you any spoilers, but I will say that this chapter caught me off guard in the fact that it's basically a little bit of a time loop. So if you make a mistake, you basically restart off at a certain point in time, and you'll find out as you watch through this chapter, or if you've already done this chapter, you'll know what I'm talking about. Now, if you're watching it right now, you can see that Aldo snuck off to talk to Shaney, and I guess visit Corinda Plains, mainly because he's missing and thinking about Eden. I will say that at this point, I really do feel that Shaney and Aldo really should ship together. I mean, at the end of the day, they're almost like soulmates. I mean, she's destined in a way to be with him. And if you don't have Shaney and you watch some of the side quests or her personal quests on YouTube, you'll know that there is a reason why the two of them are tied together. So I really would hope that later on they do become a couple. But of course, you know how Aldo and his harem are. Tons of girls want him, and he just kind of friend zones everyone. Now, a couple of other things I wanted to note. One of the cutscenes in the very beginning of this chapter is almost the same cutscene as the end of the chapter. So again, watch that and check it out. Quite interesting nonetheless, and it actually leaves us as a little bit of a cliffhanger where we're going to have to wait for future chapters in order to find out what's going on with Clarty. In terms of the puzzle itself, I've tried to film it in correct order so that you can progress through this chapter without too many hiccups. If you choose the wrong one, it's going to be quite time consuming. My older son, aka Jeff Morrison, and I do have a link to his channel in my feature channels, he kind of went through this and spent multiple hours doing this, and actually he did it before I did, being that I've actually been working a little bit more this particular weekend. So. He helped me along in this particular area to make things a little bit easier. So hopefully you enjoy this video. If you do have Thilalili, you do have to have finished this particular chapter in order to unlock her last move and her third personal quest. Anyways, like most storyline videos, I'm going to stop talking now and let you watch the rest of the video in peace. Thanks for watching! We'll see you next time.